Wow.
Okay, then
There is
let
a
me
Greek
pick.
business management graduate sitting in the center. All the best. Go ahead, team number six.
Yes, sir. Sir, we're starting. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Niharanjan Pradhan. Product management, as you know, product management is a function within a company that deals with all these parameters that I have shown in this picture, like customer development, sales, legal activities, finance, research, marketing, and all that. And also, it also deals with pricing of a product, the launch of a product, how the product is going to be marketed in the market, everything from a product being introduced in the market to the product, like as you said, the product life cycle ends. Till then, the product management continues. Then the product life cycle management is also a integrated part of product management, where it integrates different data, people, and innovate the product along the process through so new product information that is coming from the way that is coming from the customers. Coming to the next, anyone like to continue?
Yes, Nihar, I will take from here.
Excellent, excellent. Go ahead.
Okay. The objective of any product management is to come with a product of right quality, right quantity, at the right time, and present it in the market at the minimum price possible. So with these objectives, any company tries to attain the following purposes. That is, provide customer value in addition to making measurable business benefits. So customer value is nothing but it is the worth that a customer pursues against the amount he pays for a product. So the product management tries to maintain high customer value of a product, where the customer should feel that the product he has purchased is of more worth than the price he has paid for that. And to generate good amount of business revenues, this can be done by either increasing the revenues or else by decreasing the production costs. Revenues can be increased by increasing the sale of the product, and for this the product management sees that the product is perceived as of high value in the market. And for decreasing the costs, production process, say production purpose and sales and after sale services all are streamlined, and the management tries to minimize the cost of these processes. Next.
Neha, change this slide.
Okay, someone take. Would
Good
someone
job.
wants to take?
Good job. Yes, please.
Yes,
Okay.
okay, Prati, continue.
No, I'm continuing.
Okay.
So the functions of what are the functions of the product management?
Yes.
So the first function is idea generation. For the product management, we should come with the solution for the problem, and we should also search for the new opportunities what our product bring for the customers. The second point is product enhancement. To enhance the product, we should continuously do the value addition to the product at regular interval of time. Due to the product enhancement, we gain the competitive advantage. Like for we can take the example of mobile devices. Mobile devices always change their operating system. Apple always change their features. So it is the product enhancement which provides us competitive advantage. The third thing is customer satisfaction, means we should take the feedback from the customer. If customer have some problems, we should solve the problem, and from their feedback we try to improve our product. So customer satisfaction also a part of product management. And the last part is improve the product quality. To improve the product quality, we have to consider some things in our mind, like we should reduce the cost of our production. We should evaluate our production process. while evaluating our production process, we should think what we can do to improve the quality of product. We should also prepare a solid product strategy. We should also focus on quality management system, and we should do trial of our product, and market testing should be done to improve the product quality. Next slide, please. Pratyay sir.
Yeah. So I would like to continue this. There are two kinds of product management. One is strategic product management and the other is technical product management. So strategic product management deals with questions such as which market should we target, which market should we enter, and which market we should focus, which is our potential market and where growth opportunities are available. And on the other hand, technical product management deals with the features of the product, like what features we should incorporate and how we can make the product better. So both these aspects are equally important in the process of product management. And if we do product management, then we might overlook the needs of a particular product segment, which will ultimately lead to stagnation. And on the other hand, if we only focus on strategic product management, that would also be harmful to our product, as the product would lack in technical features and would eventually lose ground to other competitors. So next slide, please.
Yes, I will take this. Coming to your product management, generally includes three major things, where business, technical, and customers. But these will be managed by the product manager. A product manager is such person who have all of them have same set of skills, but it is how they use the different these set of skills in acquiring the effective product management. Here in the responsible role in the organization, which is definitely needed for the product. And coming to the different types of product management, there are majorly five types of product management. There are technical product management, where the person includes majorly the technical skills of the product. Like, we can take the example of Elon Musk here, who has the knowledge of all the products and how are they made. And coming to the designer product management, here the person we can take example of Steve Jobs, where they strongly sense the future needs of customers. They design the products so how they have been needed by the customers. And coming to the third one, it's business product manager. The business product manager operates the business or finance and other operations, where the elements of business will be considered by him. And coming to the data product manager, the data product manager is the person who takes the decisions, where the data is very critical in taking decisions most of the time. And this data product manager analyzes all the data available to take the effective decisions for the product. And coming to the third one, it's growth product manager. Here the growth product manager doesn't have a definite role. He has to simultaneously look after all the aspects, and the aim of the growth product manager is to the promotion of the product. Next slide. Can anyone else continue, or shall I?
I'll take this.
Yeah, Harman, so, please.
Product manager has two responsibilities. One is the internal responsibilities, that is developing a product, and the other is the external responsibility, where they have to market that product. So first of all, in the internal responsibility, the product manager has to have a strategy and a vision for a product they have to release. For that strategy and vision, they will take customer interviews. The customer interviews will help them in what are the needs the customer has and the product they have to develop. According to that, they will define the features and requirements of the product. They will build a roadmap and they will release that to a management. After that, management say that the product is right and it could be go further, they will go to resource for engineering that product, and then further the sales and support team will help in the product development, designing, and for the sale of this product. Next slide, please. Okay, so the external product marketing responsibilities of a product manager is to market that product. So first of all, they'll see what are the competitions present for that product in the market, and they will differentiate the product according to it. Then they will position and message it, name and brand it, and then further go with customer communication. And finally, they will do a product launch and press and analyst relation. So this will all help the product manager to product launch its product in the market and get a good positioning and branding.
Yes. Okay, great job. Great effort. Fantastic. Great effort. So there are so many compliments also coming to you. Good one, guys. Nice presentation. Excellent. Wow.